Hey, what's up, y'all? My name is Devontae, and I sacrificed my time so you don't have to. Okay, so I did my due diligence. I confirmed with you guys, who I'm assuming you guys are basketball fans. You guys went in, one of you guys went into pretty much good detail as far as telling me what happened on Monday. So again, I'm gonna go with the clarification that you guys are huge basketball fans. It seems like nothing has happened on Wednesday. It seems like everything was just based off of the show and itself. There was no competition. I see nothing of significance. Someone can tell me something else differently. I see no football. I see no hockey. I see no soccer. You guys are telling me nothing happened as far as basketball is considered. If anything, it ended on Monday. So they have nothing to talk about as far as any type of competition whatsoever. Okay, now that we have that confirmation with how everything it is, so people can, even if that was the case, I still would love to hear the excuse once again that no one has yet to engage with as far as telling me how can you get a higher rating compared to last year, compared to this year. But even that is thrown outside the window now. I'm looking at social media. I see nothing from Dave Meltzer giving out any kind of excuses whatsoever. Bro, I see nothing. Okay, so we can actually confirm this then. I'll leave the link down in the description box below. Follow along if you want to. AEW Dynamite viewership decreases. Demo also drops. Why did they have to title it like that? Why won't you just title it like we all see it? This ain't no fucking drop. This is one of the lowest, if not the lowest viewership I think I've ever seen from a regular. Nothing going up against it. No qualifiers, as in they have to go to a different station or anything like that. They were on TBS with no competition, with the obvious caveat of maybe I'm gonna be as charitable as I possibly can, as super duper charitable. I see one of you guys talking about even that was on Monday. You guys mentioned DJ Saf. He said about the Celtics game, even he's saying that's Monday. Okay, what the fuck? According to Programming Insider, 502,000 viewers watched the show on Wednesday night, drawing a 0.16. Even the rating is, I've never seen the rating that low before. I've seen 0.23. I've seen 0.22. 0.16? What the fuck? In the 18 to 49 demographic, the viewership is down from last week's episode of 681,000. Folks, 681,000 is the number that they had when they were defeated by NXT last week, and they dropped nearly 200,000 viewers from the number that we were already debating in regards to, holy shit, they're already in the 600,000s. They dropped 200,000 from that mark. They are now officially, at least with this episode, one third of the viewership number as to where they were at their peak. I've never seen that before in a wrestling. I've never seen that in a television before. Holy shit, that's crazy. The demo also dropped from last week's episode, which drew 0.23. Exactly. That's exactly what I just said. Rating in the same demographic. They're trying their best to say, what the fuck? They're like, what happened on AEW Dynamite this week? Well, we know what happened because I reviewed the show as far as what happened. Nah, bro, you can try to, you know, wiggle room your way out of this as much as you possibly can. There's no excuse to this. I don't know how you can excuse this. Like, bro, so are we now in an agreement? Like, I think before we were kind of questioning whether or not this was the case. I think we're now in an agreement, right? That 800,000 number that we used to talk about, as far as maybe there's a possibility they can get back to that, and that already in itself was already a 200,000 drop for where they were averaging about 2 years ago. Like, I said it once and I'll say it again, that number is a distant memory. That number's gone. There's no getting back to that 800,000 number, at least not at this rate. Maybe there's a possibility if they can get the creative, you know, back to tip-top shape again. But as far as we see right now, that's it. That's it. There's nowhere to go from here. That's incredible, though. You know, it's almost to the point, you know, it's going to sound weird. Because, like, you know how we always talk about AEW and we suggest things like, ah, oh, shit, you know, like AEW sucks and you want to see them get their shit together and everything like that. This is all happening during the TV contract situation, man. There's a part of me that actually kind of feels bad. Like, I wanted them to drop to a degree where it's like, fuck, get your shit together because you're seeing the numbers drop. Like, you know, like mid-600,000s and shit like that. Bruh, they drop, they're almost at 400,000. They're almost at Rampage numbers. They're about to do Rampage numbers, bro. They can actually legitimately say now they are competing with Jim Cornette reviewing their show. That's wild. Like, that's actually wild. I said it once and I'll say it again. There are YouTubers who do live shows who can get that number in like 1 or 2 hours. Again, go look at something like Moist Critical. You think I'm bullshitting? Homeboy can pull in 1 million viewers in one day. Homeboy can pull in like 200,000 views in like 3 hours, 2 hours even, sometimes even an hour. This is remarkable. And now don't get it twisted. You know, I was amongst that audience that probably turned it off towards the last, you know, 10 or 20 minutes of the show. I mean, I think, I did keep it on. I kept it on when I was uploading the show. That's when Cesaro and Neville were going at it. So I did keep it on. It was in the background, but it was still on nonetheless, though. But, like, that means no one really tuned into your show. And you know the sad part about it is? I'm still wrong. I could have sworn. I can't remember what video I made. I could have sworn I said, like, oh, you know, their core audience is around 700,000, right? 600,000, 700,000. I can't remember what video I said that in. But I remember saying, well, at least you know where they bottom out at, right? There's no way they can get any lower than this number. Not only did they get lower than that number, they damn near skipped the whole bracket. Bro, they damn near skipped the 500,000s. I was already skeptical when it came to the 600,000 and 700,000. They skipped over damn near the 500,000. Again, it's to the point now where it's like, damn, bro. Like, you're at the number now, because I remember, and someone can correct me if I'm wrong, I remember seeing Tony Khan or somebody within the AEW management talk about how when they first came to TBS or TNT or Turner Broadcasting in general, I remember somebody saying that the number that TBS or TNT, I guess at the time, were aiming at, they were aiming at something around the lines of 500,000 views, right? That was the number that they wanted to get. Well, we're now at the point where there's no competition and you're at a number that's almost lower than what TNT was even seeking out. Like, I guess right now, I don't know, if I was Tony, this would be one of those deals where it's like, motherfuckers are getting fired, right? Motherfuckers are getting fired. I'm going to put somebody in that position to take over what the fuck I'm currently doing at the moment, because we're no longer talking about, you know, your little GMO thing that you're doing. Now we're talking about life and death of your company, my dude. 500,000 for your flagship brand? 500,000? Bro, you're getting to the point now where the distance between Raw and you, you're going to get to the point where that same distance between Raw and you is going to be the distance between you and NXT. Like, NXT grew this week. I think, I can't remember the number, but it was like 720 something thousand for NXT. If I remember from seeing what I seen last night, it was like 720,000 for NXT. They beat you by 200,000 views plus with nothing but fucking green talent. I mean, I don't know what to say. Did people give up on AEW? Like, for me, I have to review the show. Like, if it wasn't for the reviewing portion, I wouldn't be watching AEW, excuse me. But, like, for even the AEW faithful, because like I said, they even went outside the boundaries of what I would have assumed to just be, like, the normal number for AEW. People have even given up. Their core audience seems like they have given up. What do you do? What do you legitimately do? Like I said, I'll tell you what you do. The time has come where you have to start chopping off heads, man. I know Tony seems like a nice guy and he doesn't want to do this and he doesn't want to do that. But my dude, the amount of money on these contracts that you've spent on and gotten no return on that investment, for real, bro. Like, you not only overspend, but you overspent for nothing. Where is the return on the investment? Mercedes, Okada, Osprey, they've been around for like 3 or 4 months now. Like, where's the ROI on all this, my dude? Like, you got nothing back on returning all this except for boring fucking wrestling. And, like, yes, I understand people are going to probably be like, and I agree, don't get it twisted. It all comes back to Tony Khan's booking, but it's not just the booking. It's more so the criticizing of what the fuck he's doing overall with the show. You know, I seen Jeff Hardy. I can't remember. I don't know if it was on Busted Open Radio, maybe. But I seen a comment or an excerpt from Jeff Hardy, and he's just recounting all the same things that everybody else who has to deal with AEW is starting to recount. And that's the fact that, yo, AEW, they're so obsessed with the wrestling that they're no longer focusing on the business aspect of it. They're no longer focusing on the core aspect of what's going to actually get fans to invest in your show. My whole thing is, why didn't you just go? I mean, you're so trying. It's so obvious. You're trying so hard to be WCW light. Why didn't you just follow the WCW approach while at the same time still getting in all that you want to get in regards to, like, your wrestling, right? You like the five-star wrestling. No one is saying you can't have the five-star wrestling. No one is saying you can't have all the cruiserweights and stuff like that. But why did they have to be a prominent fixture on the show in regards to the mid-card, the main event scene? It's up and down the card. You can't distinguish from any of these guys at all when it comes to the booking aspect or the character aspect or the wrestling at all. Everybody wrestles the same. Everybody talks the same. Everybody walks the same. You might have two or three people who are a little bit different from the rest of the crowd, one being also a standout like an MJF. But outside of that, and maybe a few others, like, you really can't distinguish from the wrestlers that you bring to the roster, right? Like, we're at the point now. I'm actually at a loss for words. I'm at a loss for words. I don't know what Tony can do at this point. I honestly don't know. I want to be nice, and I want to suggest maybe there's a way out of this. But in order for there to be a way out of this, Tony will have to get out of his own way. Like, I can't stress this enough. I can't say this enough. I'm in absolute shock that the number went down. Like, I had a feeling, and we talked about this last week. I said to myself that I felt like the number was going to go down to this week because the show hasn't been good. The show has been very, very bad. It has been trash. It's been trash as fuck. But even then, I said to myself, well, maybe there's an opportunity that they might go up a little bit, but I don't really think anything is going to happen. And, well, shit, it went well beyond not happening. Shit went bad. It went south. It went really, really, really fucking south. Oh. I honestly don't know what to say. I'm actually at a loss for words as far as how low they've gotten. I'll keep an eye out as far as Twitter is concerned, because I'm very curious as to what excuses are going to be given in regards to one of these horrendous. This is horrendous. If this is not the lowest viewership number in AEW history, for sure, without any competition, this is the lowest. I don't think I've ever seen a number this low without competition, that is. Or I gotta believe this has gotta be top three lowest viewership numbers in Dynamite history, right? If like, regardless of the situation. And yeah, it's one of those situations where you live by the sword and you die by the sword. I'm very curious as to how this is going to affect the TV ratings or the viewership numbers in regards to how they're going to renegotiate their contracts. If I'm seeing this, Warner Brother has definitely got to be seeing this, right? Discovery has definitely got to be seeing this. And it's more so you think to yourself, like, damn, bro. I don't know what to say. I'm actually at a loss for words. Like I said, all I can do is just follow the news and just keep up with what everybody's talking about. And hopefully we get more answers as to what is the response to this rating, this viewership number. And hopefully I would expect hefty changes to come, because there's no way you can be okay with what this number is. This is horrific. This is devastating. That's the best word to use. This is absolutely devastating. And I'm looking on Twitter as I'm talking right now just to see, like, is there anything else anybody else has to say in regards to any of this? No, let me look at Dave Meltzer real quick. Is he saying anything? Dave Meltzer, just to let everyone know that AEW rating, look at this. Look at this. Even Dave Meltzer can't even cuck for it anymore. He's like, just to let everyone know that AEW rating was not an error. It was the truth. And Juneteenth isn't the reason either. Even Dave Meltzer can't cover for this right now. Damn. Damn, that's fucking sad. So, y'all got some bets under and over the destruction of AEW? Damn. Fuck. All right, let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. I mean, I know most people are going to probably be celebrating this and laughing at this. I'm not going to do that, bruh. Like, it's one of those things where it's like one of those tragic I told you so's. Like, you know how like you're fucking around and you're bullshitting around, right? And like your older brother or sibling or one of your friends told you not to do something, and then like you do it and you hurt yourself for real, for real. And then they see you. The first thing they don't say is, "I told you so." They go check up on you and they go run up on you crying, trying to see what the hell is going on. That's how I feel about AEW at the moment. It's like, we all knew, except for all the AEW fans out there, we all knew it was going to get to this point. And we warned them. We told them, hey, get your booking in order so it doesn't get to this point. And now it's to the point now where it's like, yeah, I told you so, but this is not something that I wanted to tell you about. I just, it's fucking tragic, man. We'll talk about this more on the SmackDown review later on tonight if anything else pops off. Fucking tragic, man. As always, my name is Devontae, and let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. AEW, 502,000 viewers. Shake my motherfucking head. Goddamn shame. Goddamn shame.